This is a video showing how to calculate the integral of a function within SparkVue. So first I will connect my sensor here. In this case it's going to be a force sensor. This force sensor provides an acceleration data set which I'm going to integrate to determine the velocity. So to do that I'll click on my build button, create the largest display. Now I'll go down to the cross tools icon at the bottom of the screen. And I will select calculated data. Once I've done that, I'll put my cursor into the calculated data field at the top of the screen, and either from my keyboard on my computer or through the online on-screen keyboard, I'll type in the name of the function that I wish to create. In this case, I will type in velocity, and then either type in the equal sign from the keyboard or the on-screen keyboard here. Now I will go down and select Special 1 from the menu down below, and then I will click on the integral. The integral function has two arguments. The first argument is going to be the y-axis. To select this measurement, I'm going to click on the orange measurements button at the bottom of the screen. The measurements that are collected from sensors are selected by default. In this case, I'm going to go down and select my acceleration and my x-direction. You can see that it's populated this first field here. I'm now going to use the arrow button on my keyboard to advance beyond the comma here to enter in my second argument. Since I'm going to be integrating over time, I will then go down to my measurements button again, and I'm going to select time. To assign the units to this, I'll go down and click on my properties button, and then next to the units line here, I'll click on the keyboard. Double-click to select the entire units display here, and since I will be determining the velocity, I'll type in meters per second, and then click on OK at the bottom of the screen, and click on OK again. In this case, I'm going to actually want to create two calculations. My second calculation will be for the position. Again, I'll go down to Special 1 at the bottom of my display, and select Integral. Now, in this case, rather than selecting the measurement acceleration, I'm instead going to integrate my velocity calculation. So I can select my velocity by, again, going down to my measurements button. But instead, this time, instead of having the sensors tab selected, I want to click on the user entered tab. Once I've done that, I now have my velocity calculation available. I'll click on that. Again, I'll advance beyond the comma within the argument of the integral function, and I will then go down to measurements again, and since I will be integrating over time, I'll select time again. To assign proper units, I will then select on the properties button, select the keyboard next to the units display, double click, and then type in M for meters. And click on OK, and OK again, and then click on Done. And then at the very bottom of the screen, I'll click on OK again. So I'll go ahead and click on the vertical axis here to select my measurements. Now the measurements that I've created are not under sensor measurements, but are under user entered measurements. And you can see here I now have available my velocity and my position.